Have you ever used any of these words? Very, hopefully, equal, lot, got. Well, this man wants you to stop.
Well, I'm certainly not part of the aristocracy. That's definitely true.
So we settle for upper middle?
I'm a man of the people. Vox populi, vox dei.
This is Jacob Rees Mogg, an upper-class British politician who's now in a very powerful position. And in the time of crisis that the UK is now facing, this is his first act of power. Banned words and phrases. Very, due to, ongoing, hopefully, unacceptable, equal, too many eyes, yourself, lot, got, speculate, invest, in schools, etc. No longer fit for purpose. I am pleased to learn. Meet with, ascertain, disappointment, I note, understand your organisation. All non-type singulars. There is MPs, no full stop, need to write MP, after their name, need to write text, double space after four, stop, no comma, check, and imperial, measurements. Now, seeing as Mr. Rees-Mogg doesn't want people using any of these words, I've made a song using the lot of them.
Concerns, but I cannot tell you that I am pleased to learn the list of words which you determine unacceptable and worthless due to the fact of their being no longer fit for purpose. You better check your workers. When I look at Hansard, there are countless examples of you flouting your own standards. You've too many eyes yourself. What an ongoing disappointment, and thus calling into question your self-appointed anointment as the guardian and arbiter of grammatical convention. So see me after class, Rees-Mogg. You've got yourself into detention. Whether or not it was your intention, you've brought attention to the boiling tension, and contentions were all fermented. There's no point in pretending we all can be friends, and it's hard to enforce a convention in language when language is always dissenting. It wasn't always cemented in rules, semantics are how things are meant to be called. The fact that language is bending is cool, offended to trends and transcended all the attempts to control and restrain its applications, a source of endless fascination. But actually, Jacob, I've taken a minute just to ascertain whether I considered and have given it enough cogitation to safely treat this linguistic oversimplification as just a misinterpretation deserving of Floccinaucinihilipilification. Or if you're a pillock, deserving of all of this vilification. My God, Jacob Rees-Mogg, check your priorities at once. Your punctuation policies are wrong. Jacob Rees-Mogg. No and following power, please. What? Jacob Rees-Mogg. Is with all these frivolities.
You're a man that hasn't got a lot of equals. You don't want to be like the karma people. Use religion to excuse your belief stating same-sex marriages should not be legal. But I've got to give it to you, you're a man of principle. And an imbecile. But honestly, I'm really rather quite surprised to find you don't believe in hanging criminals. You're cut from a crowd developed. Despite what everyone says, you're not a villain. You're a little bit privileged, very old-fashioned, but you stick to principles with a passion. But when you're in the chicken coop, you get covered in chicken poop. Why did you give a speech to the traditional Britain group? Now you can never say that it's something you didn't do. You also stopped and planned stuff with Steve Bannon, didn't you? Never change your baby's nappies, that's what nannies do, naturally. Anyway, you've got an allergy, an allergy. Jacob is the member for the 18th century. If contemporary is an ailment, he's the remedy. He doesn't want anything to do with anything that is in living memory. It's not cricket if you've not got a ticket for entry into the gentry. He isn't so friendly. Nah, that's a fib, he's a man of the people on which we each can depend. Oh, Jacob, I speculate you won't reply, though hopefully you do. Jacob, I've invested so much of my time in you. And how should I refer to you? Is it Earl or Duke, Baron Earl or Sir? You're sincerely Daniel Chuckman, Duggery, Digby,